Hello everyone, this is Ufumao Gaga, CEO of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. Today, I'll talk about the new 1099 NEC form and show you some updates you need to make in your QuickBooks Online file. Here is an example of the 2019 1099 miscellaneous form. You will notice box 7 is listed as non-employee compensation in this form. As of 2020, the IRS changed this form to now split out non-employee compensation into its own separate form. And it moved everything else such as rents and other income into a brand new 1099 miscellaneous form. Here's the new 2020 1099 NEC form. You will notice that what we used to call box 7 non-employee compensation is now called box 1 non-employee compensation in this particular brand new form. Going forward, you will be required to file two types of 1099 forms in January of each year. So all your non-employee compensation will be recorded in the 1099 NEC form, and all your rents and other 1099 miscellaneous income will go on the brand new 2020 1099 miscellaneous form that you are seeing here. In addition to this, and to ensure that your reports are accurate, you will need to update the mapping of your expense accounts to the correct boxes in the 1099 wizard in QuickBooks Online. If this is your first time using the 1099 wizard in QuickBooks Online, the steps that I'm about to show you are still applicable to you. If you have previously completed the 1099 wizard step before, maybe in 2019, you must redo your mappings in QuickBooks Online since the boxes have changed. To get to the 1099 mapping screen, move your cursor to the payroll tab and select contractors. Click on prepare 1099s to enter the mapping wizard screen. You have the option to use QuickBooks Online to file your 1099s or use an external filing system. I am only completing enough of the steps in this wizard for the correct vendor data to show up in the 1099 transaction detail report. If this is your first time completing this process, your button will probably say Get Started. If this is not your first time completing this process, you will see this Continue Your 1099 button. The system will ask you to complete your company information. The information listed here must match your legal name and address as it appears on your tax return. For nonprofit organization, this has to match your IRS determination letter or your Form 990. For small business owners, this will match your Schedule C tax return, or for corporations, this will match your Form 1120 tax return. So enter the missing information and click Next. In this step 2, this is where you will map all of your expense accounts to the correct 1099 form boxes. A brand new thing that Intuit added when they updated the 1099 wizard for 2020 is that they added the 1099 form names right next to each box. I love this because it helps you not make the mistake of mapping a non-employee compensation expense account to the wrong 1099 form. So I'll spend some time here selecting all of my non-employee compensation accounts, mapping them to the right box, and then also mapping my rent accounts to the brand new 1099 miscellaneous form. So just keep watching as I go through this process. So I've done the mapping. I recommend reviewing everything to make sure you have captured all of the 1099 accounts and then click Next. Step 3 shows you all of the service providers that meets the W-9 form requirements so that you can update their contact information. You can continue the rest of the steps in this wizard if you are filing your 1099s in QuickBooks Online. For the sake of this video, I will stop here and click Save and Finish later. Now that I have completed the process of mapping the expense accounts to the correct 1099 boxes, I'll run the 1099 detailed reports to verify my data. To run the report, click on the Reports tab. Under the Standard tab, search for 1099 Transaction Detail Report. Here is a transaction detail report. You can export this report to Excel or PDF or email it to your accountant. I recommend reviewing this report and following the 1099 instructions to make sure all your vendor payments that are not credit cards are showing under each vendor. If you forgot to include an expense account, you can always go back to the 1099 wizard screen to update your mapping. One thing that I just noticed in this 1099 transaction detail report is the name of the 1099 form is listed as a separate column. This makes it so much easier for you to differentiate which data goes on which form, especially if you're using an external filing system to prepare and e-file your 1099s. So I really love this. Watch the next video to learn how to track the W-9 form status of your vendors and contractors using custom fields in QuickBooks Online Advanced.